Welcome back to WFMJ Community Connection. Have you ever heard of Lit Youngstown? If you haven't, then today you will. I would like to welcome to WFMJ Community Connection my friend Karen Schubert. Good morning, Karen.
Good morning.
Oh, I'm so glad you're here.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm very grateful for this opportunity.
Well, I'm going to tell you what, any opportunity to talk about books and literature, count a sister in. I'm in.
All right.
Tell my viewers, what is Lit Youngstown?
So Lit Youngstown is a nonprofit dedicated to the literary arts. We have programs for writers, readers, and storytellers. And we started in 2015. So we have programs all year long. Mm-hmm. We have a readers a series where people come in every month to read some of their work. Tonight, actually, we'll be featuring some YSU essayists.
Wow.
Who will be reading down at Sue's at the Soap Gallery.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, you know, I know at Youngstown State, they have the Penguin Review, where mm-hmm. a lot of students can write, even some faculty can write their thoughts, and, you know, it gets published in a book form, but that's really cool
that's
to have.
That's exactly right. Yeah. You know, I was an editor of the Penguin Review.
Get out.
Before that, my very first publication was in the Penguin Review.
Stop it.
That made me so happy.
I bet you were proud.
I was excited.
Wait, I was going to say, Karen, that's amazing, but that's great. Things that are published, okay, when I say published, and to my viewers, when I say published, it becomes a part of history. Mm-hmm. It's definitely a part of history. But what made me call you was I got an email saying that you were going to have a writing workshop. And I said, well, you know, I can have you to come on and talk about the writing workshop. But now it's literally sold out, and it wasn't for sale. It was free. All people had to do was just register and give you their information. Tell us what that writing workshop is going to be about, and will there be any more?
We've had a wonderful response. It's very exciting. So the winter writing camp will take place at the public library and at St. John's right next door on February 16th. And all day long, we'll have 5 or 6 sessions going at the same time for writers of all ages and all experience levels. Of you learning about prose, how to write poetry. We'll be doing some storytelling, and it's just going to be a really fun day.
Wow. And it was open to the public, free of charge,
even
going to give them lunch. I mean,
lunch,
come on now.
And free childcare.
Oh,
we really want everyone who would like to come to be able to come.
That's good.
It was sad for me when we closed it, but also very joyful because that many people were interested. So
right.
That's really terrific.
Right. And for it to be quote unquote sold out is a good thing. Now, it's something that you brought with you, and I didn't even know that you were going to bring it. I'm glad that you did. But the Phenomenal Women 12 Youngstown Stories was done through Liz and Lit Youngstown, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, this book, it's special to me, folks, because it features my godmother, who was Louise Frances Payne. Mm-hmm. And she lived to be over 100 years old, but she shared her story in this book. And I remember when the book was launched, and it was the worst weather ever. And I said, how are we going to get a 100-year-old woman out to the church, to First Presbyterian? I don't know if we can do it, but we did it. But every woman was there, and their stories were phenomenal.
They were so great.
Right.
It moved us to the core to hear their stories. They're beautiful and heartbreaking and poignant and funny and tender. It was a wonderful experience for us to be able to talk to them, and we're so grateful for them to tell us their stories. It's really the history of our community.
I think it's great.
It
makes me very enthusiastic, and I'm always enthusiastic, but that makes me even more enthusiastic. I hear the book is sold out.
The book is sold out. We've sold quite a few boxes of them, but we will order a new one.
Really? So
yes.
So they will be reordered and
yes,
republished?
Yes, we work with City Printing.
Oh,
yes.
You know, don't you just love City Printing?
Love them.
Okay, they're local. That's the
right.
way to do it,
That's
right?
really important to us.
Mm-hmm. Local connection.
That's exactly
and
right.
And where else to tout it on other than your locally owned and operated television station?
That's
I love
exactly
it.
Right.
I love
yes,
it.
That's perfect.
Now, tell us more about Lit Youngstown, and it's not lit, we're lit, you know, drinking or anything,
no,
but
that's
but
right.
What else is on the agenda
well,
for lit?
Joke, not that lit. We're happy people, but it's about reading and writing. So we also have writer's circle where people who have written new work, let's say mm-hmm. they've written something and they want to have some feedback maybe from other writers. We all gather around a table and share each other's work.
Wow.
And in this really gentle community of writers. So
wow.
that's really helpful too. And then we also have a book discussion. So every month we sit down and read a book. We have read a book together and we mm-hmm. sit down and discuss it. This month we'll be talking about Austin Channing Brown's book.
Wow.
Which is called...
that's okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Sorry.
Brain freeze, but that's
I
all
know,
right. That's all right. But that's all right. That's
I'll
all
think,
right.
Okay,
but you're
going to
be talking about the book
mm-hmm.
and the discussion. It's a friendly discussion.
Yes, exactly.
It is. Now, what
exactly.
about... You said it's called...
Black Dignity and an Age of Whiteness.
That's she got
yes.
it. Black Dignity in an Age of Whiteness. Well, all right.
Mm-hmm.
And you
it's
know
a wonderful
what?
Book.
I believe
enjoying it.
It
very much.
I believe
I'm learning
it.
A lot.
Well, Karen, the other thing I was going to say was when you're in the writer's circle, how often does that happen? Every month?
Every month. Mm-hmm.
Really? Well, mm-hmm. maybe I might join you because
please
as I was
do.
Sharing with you, you know, and now I'll share with my viewers when I was ill and out, I couldn't move. I couldn't do anything. I had to be in one place and had to just sit, you know, or lie down. And I took the time to write down little things that my father would say. And he would say little aphorisms. And next thing I knew, I ended up with 28 aphorisms
that's
that turned
incredible.
Into 28 chapters. And, you know, I said, wow, you know, I need to publish a book.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody's writing a book these days. I mean, not everybody, but, you know, I get books, people that are authors, they'll come and, you know, send me the book and say, read it and tell me what you think. And it's like, well, there are some typographical errors here.
Mm-hmm.
This word is spelled wrong. Did you not have somebody to edit it?
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to be mean to people and say, get your book right, and then I'll have you on and we can talk about it. But
it's a really interesting time in the world of writing and publishing because people have a perception that publishing is just, I had somebody call me and say, I wrote a book, how do I get it on Amazon?
Yeah.
But that's actually skipping a few steps.
Right.
So one thing we want to do is help people understand how publishing works. So
mm-hmm.
I'll be leading a workshop this summer on submitting work for publication.
See, people need to understand and know that
mm-hmm.
because just having stuff written that's not a good book make.
That's exactly right. It's a great first step.
Mm-hmm.
We also have a fall literary festival every year where we bring in really experienced, highly acclaimed writers from around the country,
wow.
as well as different presses. And
mm.
we, for 2 days, we have sessions on writing, editing, publishing, just all kinds of storytelling and
wow.
and the literary arts in the community.
And that's going to happen in the fall?
That's in the fall. This year will be October 4th and 5th.
Oh.
That's not free, but it's pretty affordable. We
mm-hmm.
think there'll be a $40 early bird cost for 2 days of programming. We think that's pretty
$20 a day. Yeah.
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 And what they will garner and gain from being there, that's priceless.
It's, you know? We're really excited about the quality of presenters that we've attracted.
That's
yeah,
good. Karen, I get excited about books. I always
mm-hmm.
have, and I always will. But I'm proud to be able to say that my cousin by marriage, Angela Johnson, you know, she's written so many teen books. She's an award-winning author.
Mm-hmm.
And she's my cousin by marriage. She's my husband's cousin. And when I would read her books, I would think, oh, my gosh, mm-hmm. this is so good. But it was all a reflection of the Floyd Butler Pinkert family. And I would say to us, don't you know who this is in this book? And he's, no, they're totally oblivious. She's writing about you. She may have changed the names or changed the gender of the person, but
mm-hmm.
that's you, or that's mm-hmm. the, you know, it's
right.
so interesting to see how people, how authors can garner that information and put it in prose and make it so interesting. Fictionalized history.
That's right. There is a lot of nonfiction in fiction.
I know, right? 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 That's an oxymoron, right? I love it. Well, Karen, I am just so glad that you took your time to come here this morning in the rain to talk about Lit Youngstown and to share it with my viewers. And I want to be able to put your information out there when you have another workshop. I'm going to be early. I'll be an early bird and get it to our viewers so that if somebody does want to write a book or they do want to get something published, that they can contact you.
Thank you so much. Well, if they go to our website, there's a little about tab, mm-hmm. and they can click on the link to join our newsletter.
Okay.
And I send out one newsletter every month to let people know that what's coming up in the following month.
Oh, okay. All right. So they would go to your website. Can you mm-hmm. tell me that website once again?
Lit, Youngstown.org.
Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Well, that's great. Karen, thank you for joining me this morning.
Thank you
I love
so
having
much.
Your smiling face here.
Oh, you're very lovely. Thank you so much.
Thank you. We're going to take a quick break, and we are going to be right back with the Youngstown Mahoning Public Library. We'll be right back.